Hey friends, the Azure Instance Metadata Service provides information about running virtual machine instances that can be used to manage and configure your virtual machines. In this episode, Supriya is here to give us an update on what's new in the service, such as how VM vendors can now detect if the VM is running in an Azure environment, today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Senior Engineer Supriya Kumari and we're going to talk about the Azure Instance Metadata Service.
Yes, today I'll actually cover the Azure Instance Metadata Service, which is out there for a long time, but I'll give you a quick recap of what the Azure Instance Metadata Service does and all the new features which we added onto it. So if you know, Azure Instance Metadata Service is a service which gives you information about a running VM so you can manage and configure your VM. We get information like which region the VM is running in, what's the VM size, what's the networking information, like the IP address, the private IP address, the public IP address, and all that which will be needed to configure that VM. So all you do is from your running VM, you go to this well-known non-routable HTTP endpoint, and you just query for the instance information from the VM, and then you get details of all the information which is actually necessary. And so if we can just do a quick demo of how that VM will look like. Here I have a VM which is set up in Linux. It's it's a Linux VM which is running in Azure, and here I'm actually querying the instance endpoint.
And now that IP address, that 169, forgive my ignorance, but when I usually see 169 dot something, it's like maybe I didn't get an IP address. That's a special IP address. You said non-routable?
Yes, it is a non-routable special IP address. It's in an IEEE standard which says, yes, nobody can, you won't get a response from it, but since you're on Azure, you get a response from this well-known non-routable IP address. And here, when you query for it with a metadata slash instance tag, you actually get all the instance metadata about that VM. Here, just to note that here, the API version is a mandatory version. So we are strictly versioned, and the most recent version which we have is 2018.10.01. And the response which you get can be in JSON as well as text. The default response is in JSON. So if we look here, if we just run this query, we can see that the VM is actually located in the Azure public cloud. Now you'll be wondering, what is this and how is this information even relevant? Like when you're a developer and you want to exercise certain code paths when you are in a sovereign cloud as compared to when you are in a public cloud, you can actually make use of this variable to figure out how and which parts of the code to enable or disable.
I see. So a sovereign cloud would be like a Germany cloud or a China
yes,
cloud.
Yes, or the US government cloud.
Okay. And it's interesting because I'm noticing that there's no authentication here because you are running in the context of the VM.
Yes, right? That's
so
right.
This is different than calling the REST APIs that are available to me from the outside of Azure.
Yes. Yes, that's right. The only security we have is because you're calling from within the VM, we actually expose it as an HTTP endpoint, so it's easier for you, and we are guaranteed that, yes, you are calling from within the VM.
And the fact that it's a non-routable IP address means that no one's sitting in between me and the outside. I'm guaranteed I'm talking to Azure, right?
Yes, that's right.
But I'm not talking to my own virtual machine, right? The service is running in the node.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, that's right. So we have the service running in the node, and it gets internally routed to the service, and you get the required details.
Okay.
So the other other information which we have is where is this VM located. Like this is located in West Central US, and you have the name of the VM, the offer, whether it's and which type of OS it is, whether it's a Linux OS or a Windows OS, as well as we have a new field called the plan information. So if you are an Azure Marketplace vendor, you can actually specify which is what's the image name, the product, and the publisher. So I have a similar one for a Bitnami, where I have a Bitnami image, and you can make the same query and see that I have the plan information populated here.
Ah, okay, so Bitnami is one of the vendors that has products that you can have available. Are you saying that they can then query to see if it's true that they are in Azure and then change their licensing appropriately?
Yes, that's right. So here you have other details like to enable your calls for if you are a ISV and you get a support call and you want to know the other details about the VM, you can actually just ask the customer to to query this compute endpoint and get all the details like the subscription ID, the resource group name, as well as the VM ID for that unique VM. and probably the size and the public SSH keys, which you can probably use to query that VM. Mm.
You know, you're making me realize also that if I were running an application that I was selling in the Azure Marketplace, then I could, like you said, have the customer go to that endpoint, but I could also put that and integrate it into my support page so they could visit special application slash support. You're saying my application can count on that instance metadata. I could then populate it into a support page and collect it and use that for support as well.
Yes, that's right.
Interesting. And you said it's strictly versioned, which means that you say that there's one from just a few months ago.
Yes.
I assume there's previous ones as well. Those aren't going to go away. Those versions stay
around. The versions always stay in there. Just that we add new fields to it, and we do update our documents periodically with, okay, this is what was in the latest one, this are the new updates, this is the additional field you can query on. So you have all that information handy.
Okay, cool. So then as a vendor, I can go and query to see which versions are available and then get that extra information, like the new plan data.
Yes, that's right. And the other thing is, the other addition which we did is now you can, as a marketplace vendor, you might have a scenario in which, suppose you're supporting a certain version of your image, and now one fine day you decide that going forward, only if the image is running in Azure that you want to provide updates for it. So how will you guarantee that your virtual machine is actually running in Azure? So to make your life easier, we introduced a new endpoint called attested. So this will, so when you query this endpoint, you're actually guaranteed that you get a response from Microsoft. So I know this is not quite.
It looks scary. Is that a Base64 encoded something?
Yes, so it's a, you're right. It's a Base64 encoded signature, which we get from Microsoft. And just to make our lives easier, I have a script which actually decodes that.
Nice job.
Thank you. So here it decodes, here what I'm doing is making a curl call as I did before to the endpoint attested with the document, and here, again, this is API version, so we introduced attested in the version 2018-10-01.
Right.
And we have an optional user-specified nonce value, which is just your 10-digit string which a user can specify. And then we do support this in JSON. And here what we are doing is extracting the signature part from the response. We are doing a Base64 encoding, decoding of the response and extracting the certificate as well as the issuer information. So we can actually go down the certificate chain and extract what's the intermediate certificate, what was the subject name, and indeed validate that if the response came from Microsoft or not. So let's run the script here and see what's the response we get.
All right.
So here when we run, we see that the verification was successful. This is a non-same nonce value which we specified in the request. If the user didn't specify the nonce value, we'll return the latest UTC timestamp. And then we also have some information about the VM, like the plan information as we covered before, as well as the timestamp on which the document was created. So for performance reasons, we do cache your response the first time you queried. So the timestamp basically has a created on timestamp and the expiry timestamp. Created on timestamp is a timestamp when you first queried, and it expires 6 hours from after that.
Okay. That's very clever. It makes me realize that, you know, there are going to be people out there that are going to try to fake being a part of the metadata instance. They're going to go and grab an image, try to fool the image into running locally, and get free software. And this is a really nice, clean, and very elegant way to figure out what's going on. You're really getting a true cryptographically significant certificate from Microsoft to say, this is really, we are in Azure.
Yes. So as you look here, we have the certificate subject name, which is metadata.azure.com, which is the certificate which we used for all the public clouds.
Okay.
We have different version of the same certificate for sovereign clouds, like for US government, we have Azure metadata.azure.us, and similarly for China and the German governments, we have different certificates. So you can use that to validate that you are indeed running on Microsoft.
Okay, so you're saying that not only can we detect that we're running in a sovereign cloud, but we can attest to the fact that this is true. So then for, you know, for high security environments like running in a government cloud, we are giving a real attestation that this is legitimately running in that cloud.
Yes, that's right. And as you can see, the issuer is Microsoft, and we did validate that the certificate chain is from Baltimore, and it's a valid Microsoft certificate.
Very cool. And that one's new as well, right? The
that's
attestation.
Yes, that's the newest one. So this is all the updates I have from that Instance Metadata Service. So hopefully it was something which was helpful, and we love to hear feedback from you.
Yeah, this is super interesting. A lot of great information. People don't know that this exists, and you should be using it, the Azure Instance Metadata Service. Thank you so much, Supriya, for sharing that with me. I am learning all about how to query my virtual machines, find out where they're living, if they're in Azure, if they're in a sovereign cloud, using the Azure Instance Metadata Service today on Azure Friday.